Are you looking for an alternative for Uptime Robot or Pingdom? Well, there's a service that's called MonSpark, and it does more than just uptime monitoring. One of my favorite features is that it can monitor the performance of your site, and it can do a whole lot of things. So let's go check it out. MonSpark can do a whole lot of things aside from just doing uptime monitoring. Now, before I jump into this, let me show you the deal that's going on right now. It's a lifetime deal that starts off at $69, and let me show you what that actually gets you. So the lifetime deal means that you pay once and you can use it forever. And the license tier one gets you access to one user, so no teammates, 75 monitors, which is more than enough for most of us, and 10 status pages. If you need more, jump into license tier two and some extra features in license tier three, which would be source code monitoring, network monitoring, and who is monitoring. They also have up to license tier five, which gives you more monitors and more users if you actually need them. I think most people would be fine with license tier one, but if you want to get those extra features, jump into license tier three at least, okay? Now, if you want to grab these, there will be a link in the description, which helps me out with a small commission. Now, let's check out MonSpark. I have connected my site for several days now, and like I said, it does more things than just an uptime monitoring. Now, my favorite feature is the performance monitor, which is a lighthouse audit. Now, this is going to let me know if the site speed has changed. Now, that's really interesting because some uptime monitors don't have these features, and there's several of these that we can create. There's some of them coming soon, and some of them are beta stage. Now, if you go to create monitor here on the top, we're gonna be able to view each one of these individually and see what they are actually for. Now, there's also the text monitoring, so there's changes in the text, a screenshot monitoring in case there's changes also. So it monitors a whole lot of things, not just the website if it goes down or up, right? So it does a whole lot of things. The IP blacklist, DNS monitor, cookie monitoring, URL monitor, REST API monitor, this is coming soon, trace route monitoring, and there's several of these. Now, let's jump into one of these, okay? So first of all, once you add your site, in this case, I've connected two monitors for my site, which is SaaSmaster.net. And the two monitors I connected is a lighthouse audit, and it's going to let me know the speed changes. So the status is up, performance, the accessibility, best practices, SEO, and PWA. Now, this is created at 27 days ago, so it has all this information. And the uptime monitor for this one, okay? Now, if I wanted to create one of these, I'll just go into create a monitor. If I want to create for the lighthouse, which is the one that I like, you set the website here, enter the name for it, check the intervals. So for example, these are the intervals you have available for every day. If you want more, well, you need to upgrade for 12 hours or 3 hours, okay? Request settings. So for example, where do you want to request this from? So in this case, it's gonna do it from Europe. So that's where it's going to do the test for the speed. The emulation device by desktop, the user agent. So if you need to test it, you know what, the browser that I'm using is different than this. Instead of using Mozilla, App WebKit, or Chrome, I'll use another one. Well, you can change it. Notification settings. So you have this notifications here for this. So depending, warn me if the performance score changes more than percentage of. So it'll warn you, okay? Warn if the accessibility score changes. And for each one of these practices, you can change the score threshold. So it notifies you. And you can set the email here or emails, okay? And you can test the notification here to see how it goes. So this is what I like about it. It lets me know if there's a performance change. So if something is going on with my server, so it's not just about the site being up. I mean, I know it's up, it's not down, but what about the performance? Why is it loading, for example, I don't know, in 10 seconds instead of one like it was before? So something is wrong, and this is going to warn me in that case. So it's pretty cool that we have that option. Now, there's also more monitors. Like I said, there's a text monitor, uptime monitor. They have several of these. Basically, they're down to earth. They do what they say exactly here. Now, other things that you can do is, for example, the status page. If you need to create one of these, you can create one. For example, I'll say just test. So I'll just drag this. For example, I just want to check both of these out or the sites that you have. Let's create the status page. Yes, created. There we go. It's been created. Let's go ahead and view the status page. And here we go. Now, this is pretty neat, and I'll tell you why. Because if you have an extra monitor or a side window in your computer and you're always taking care of your sites for your clients, well, you're actually viewing it here to know how they're actually doing. So that's pretty cool that we have that option there. You can edit the status page if you like, and you have all these settings available. I won't go through them right now, okay? So there's a surfaces section. You can have the availability score, secure score, the SEO score, which is coming soon, and the integrity score. You can see the availability metrics. You can see them here, security metrics. You can create a monitor for security, the surface flow for this. So it looks nice, right? And then we have the integrations. Now, this is where it's falling short right now because it should have webhooks. Webhooks enables us to integrate with any other option that we have that we want. For example, they have Zapier, which is pretty popular, but what if we're using Public Connect, Integrately, Make, etc., all of those? Well, we need webhooks to connect to those or at least API access. But for now, you have Zapier, you have Discord, Slack, and Microsoft Teams. And if you upgrade, you have these options available, right? We also have the profile options here. The Teams, now if you have team members, depending on the plan that you're on, in this case, I only have one, which is me. I don't need anyone else. But if you have options, you can add your team members here. So that is MonSpark. Like I said, there's several monitors available. You can check these out and see if it's worth grabbing this deal or not. Like I mentioned, most people would be fine with license tier one, which is $69 for the lifetime deal. Things that I dislike about it is that they don't have webhooks. But aside from that, it's actually pretty nice. It does what it has to do. But there you go. If you want to grab it, I'll be leaving the link in the description. Well, that's a wrap.